Hello, girls.
Hello.
Timothy D. McGee at your service.
Mr. McGee, you're an American, thank heaven.
Most of the people we've met over here seem to be foreigners.
Well, what brings you girls to London?
Our mothers, and we have to go to churches and museums all the time.
Oh, yes, I wish there was something exciting going on.
You're in luck. Today is Derby Day.
Who's Derby?
No, no, that's their way of saying Derby. Today's the English Derby. Easy now. Now, I've been a racetrack man ever since my daddy stood me on a stool to shoo flies off the horses. And the favorite today is Yankee Doodle.
Oh, an American horse.
Sure, and ridden by an American jockey.
I'm betting on him then.
Me too.
Take it from McGee, any horse ridden by this jockey is more than likely to run in the money.
Well, what's his name?
Jones.
Jones. Jones.
Well, thank you ever so much, Mr. McGee. Well, let's go and get lots and lots of money.
Paging Mr. Timothy McGee.
Yeah, right here.
Yes, sir.
And here you are.
Thank you, sir. Ooh, cripes! Thank you very, very much, sir.
What did I just give him? All these English coins look alike. Why don't they have real money over here? Look to your right and guess who is behind the newspaper. Floribel Fly!
Oh, Mac, you old southern fried thing!
When did you come to London?
Jump off the boat train this morning. I figured you'd be here for the Derby.
Sure. Oh, it's good to see you, Flo.
Yeah, I heard you flirting with those schoolgirls just now. Same old ladies' man, McGee.
Except where you're concerned. Oh, good old Flo! You're the only woman I know I can treat just like a man.
Thanks.
Hey, tell me, are you still a reporter for the San Francisco Searcher?
I am society editor now. They sent me over to cover the social aspects of the Derby. Which reminds me, I would love an interview with Johnny Jones. Can you help me out?
Sure thing. Yeah, right. Johnny's on his way from Paris right now. He's due at the hotel anytime.
Say, Mac, the boys in our sports department tell me Johnny's not going to ride for you when he comes back home.
No, no, nothing settled yet.
How could Johnny not ride for you?
Well, you know, Johnny's not that little runt in short pants who used to skip school and hang around the stable.
Wow.
He's a man now and he has to think for himself.
But you practically raised him.
I don't want that to influence his decision. Anthony Anstey will probably help him a lot more.
Anthony Anstey? Well, he's the biggest thief in the racing business.
Mm. Well, I guess you know he's engaged to be married. His fiancée's here in London.
Anthony Anstey is engaged to be married to who? Tell me.
Well, she's this rich widow that he met on the boat coming over.
Uh-huh.
She's from San Francisco.
San Francisco? I bet I know her.
She's the sister of the late Copper King.
Mrs. Kenworth? Anthony Anstey is going to marry Miss... Oh, my.
What is it, Flo?
Well, now, that means that if Mrs. Kenworth is here in London... Mac, I haven't told you the real reason I'm here. I am sitting on a story about this Derby that has front page written all over it.
Front page? Is it about Johnny?
Well, read it and see.
Oh, now if it's about Johnny, you gotta tell me.
No, you got a big southern mouth.
I don't know better than to try and pry secrets out of you. Well, I better get down to the barbershop and get spruced up for the race. Goodbye, Flo.
Somehow, when it comes to me and him, it is always goodbye, Flo.
Floribel! Oh, Floribel!
Goldie, honey, we're in trouble.
Guess what I found?
Good news, I hope, because we could use it.
Look! A picture of Johnny.
Oh.
It really is very lifelike, isn't it?
Yes.
Anyway, I was gazing into those miraculous, droopy eyes, and I was thinking about you, Floribel.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense. Listen, Goldie, I have to tell you.
I was thinking about you, Floribel. Oh, darling, Floribel, because you are the one who brought me over to London so my Johnny and I could be together again.
Yes, I am, but
you single-handedly got me out of that horrid convent school.
Goldie!
And you were magnificent in Sister Mary Elizabeth's office. Remember when you said, the whole point, sister, is to keep Goldie's trip to Europe a secret so we can surprise her aunt who is touring the Holy Land.
Goldie, your aunt. That's what I have to tell you. Your aunt.
Here we are in London, and this is the day I'm going to meet my Johnny again. Oh, Floribel. Look at that mouth. I can almost see the lips moving. Oh, Johnny. You are absolutely the most exquisite. The most wonderful boy alive. I think you are a wonderful boy, honest and true, I do, dear. You made things seem different to me. I'm not the girl that I
scene, but I have to tell you, Goldie, your aunt, Mrs. Kenworth, is here in London.
Oh, my aunt here. My aunt here? I thought she was on a tour of the Holy Land.
Well, her plans change.
If she finds out you brought me over to London to meet Johnny, she'll kill me.
No, she'll kill me, and you'll be shipped back to that convent in California, probably permanently. Oh, I knew it was wrong to bring you over here like this, but what a magnificent scoop for the Searcher. The inside story of the elopement of the copper heiress and the world's greatest jockey. Oh.
Cheer up, Floribel. London is the biggest city in the world. The chances are my aunt will never even know I'm here.
Well, I haven't told you everything. Your aunt is certain to be at the race. She's gotten herself engaged to a sportsman since she left home.
Engaged?
Yes.
I don't believe it, Aunt Annie.
Oh, now listen, it's not that funny. This Anthony Anstey,
he's what, Floribel? Do go on.
He's coming toward us right this very minute.
But he mustn't know I'm here. Well, what am I going to do?
Well, you can't be yourself. Oh, here, quick, put this on. Be French.
Ah, Signorina Flock.
Mr. Anstey. My, how continental you've become.
Really? Oh. Here to cover the derby, I expect.
Well, of course.
Oh, yes, this is an acquaintance of mine, a French acquaintance. May I present Mademoiselle Rosario Franchette, Mr. Anstey.
Delighted.
Oui.
Ah, does she speak English?
Very little.
But oui, I do speak your English.
Charming! Oh. And you're from France?
That is correct. I am a Parisian.
And what is it brings you to London, mademoiselle?
But the curse, the great West. Ah. I am, how you say, a sporting woman.
What?
Well, well. Waiter? Waiter! Bottle of Dom Perignon 91, please.
Oh, Monsieur Asti, I fear you are flirting with me.
Well, I didn't think you little mademoiselles feared things like that. I've heard all about you.
And I've heard all about you.
Heard what, Miss Floribel?
Why, that you are engaged to be married.
Oh, that.
You seem to take your engagement very lightly, monsieur.
No, indeed. My fiancée's a fine little lady, anxious for you to meet her.
Oh, we can't wait.
By the way, Miss Floribel, how'd you like a little scoop for your paper?
Sure, let's have it.
Concerns my fiancée's niece, Miss Gates.
Ah, oui, continue, s'il vous plaît.
Yeah, charming girl, I hear.
Charming.
Quite a little beauty.
Oh, tell me more.
Well, I've arranged something wonderful for her.
Really? What?
Marriage to the Earl of Bloomsbury.
Marriage?
Well, that's news. All right. Who is this Earl of Bloomsbury?
Oh, a title, don't you know? Royalty. I understand he's also a fine-looking gentleman.
I see. Then you have not met him.
No. He'll be in London next week.
Ah, and what about the niece, Mademoiselle Gates? What does she have to say about this?
Say? Well, she's just a schoolgirl. Hasn't any say in it at all.
No say.
Besides now, what American girl isn't dying to marry an earl?
Oh, well, I can think of one or two.
Lord, the time! How we must run!
Oh, Mademoiselle Franchette! We have yet to speak of Paris, the opera, the theater, La Rive Gauche.
Oh, oui. Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Come, chère Floribel. I have just remembered a very important idea I must tell you.
Goodbye, Mr. Anstey.
Ta-ta.
Your champagne, sir.
Well, the little mademoiselle has left. Shall you and I sit here and drink it together? Run along now, you booby. This world is littered with idiots, isn't it? Hmm? That's one. Johnny Jones, well, he certainly is another. I don't think I'll have any trouble getting him to ride for me as opposed to that cornpone McGee. You see, I've already sent Johnny a check for a nice big bundle for first call on his services. Oh, speaking of idiots, you ought to meet this so-called fiancée of mine, this Mrs. Kenworth. Now, I suppose you think I'm marrying her just because she's got $20 million. Well, I'd marry her if she had 40 million. You see, all this billing and cooing is just greasing my way into Kenworth's purse. I'll have my hands on her fortune and that niece's too. Had papers drawn up with this Earl of Bloomsbury. Secret, of course. But the minute that little Gates fool becomes the Duchess of Bloomsbury, 50% of her fortune slips right into my pocket. Now, don't I look forward to those wedding bells?
Anthony, Anthony?
The same.
Ooh, the large American racing magnate?
Yes.
Allow me to introduce a sing-song, a sports editor picking cassette.
Sports editor, eh? Well, what about that? Well, Mr. Sing or Mr. Song, whatever it is you call yourself, I ain't got any statement for the Chinese press.
Ooh, no misunderstanding, no statement. My business with you is great Chinese lottery.
You mean the dreadful Chinese lottery that's been plaguing San Francisco? I have nothing to do with the lottery.
Ooh, no, wait. I forgot code. The yellow lock is rising. Woo for the lake.
Why didn't you say so in the first place? Ooh. The Eagle approves.
Ooh. We must talk.
How much is your syndicate willing to pay for, oh, a quarter share of the lottery? Ooh,
50 a million yen, if you really own a lottery.
Of course I do. We can't speak here. Come up to my suite in an hour.
Okie dokie.
Another idiot. Well, the dumber the better, eh? This Chinese nitwit and his syndicate, they want to buy into the lottery? Well, it just means I'll have more money for my own personal desires, which, by the way, aren't one bit grandiose. You see, I don't need so very much to make me happy. How seldom will you meet a man as through this world you go? A man, I mean, who's satisfied with life. He may be blessed with wealth, but where's his health? Oh, don't you know? His fight for millions brings him care and strife. The king, both great and grand, who has a land at his command, will want his flag to reach another shore. Ah, this life I lead is greed, though there are some things I need. If I had them, I would ask for nothing more. All I want is $50 million. And ermine to protect me from the cold. If I only knew how stocks would go on Wall Street and was living in a mansion built of gold. But soon I won't be wasting time on daydreams, for soon I'll have an heiress for my wife. Then if only I were able to have Jonesy in my stable, if he earned a pretty penny and I never gave him any, and the law would never hound me and the women would surround me and success came free and gratis, then I know that I'd be satisfied with life.
Where's the bar? Come on, let's go for a little drink.
How dare you?
Jeez, he's got a mean disposition.
Did you call me, sir?
How would I call you, sir? You're supposed to call me, sir. Can you beat that?
Do you feel like a cup of tea, sir?
No, I don't feel like a cup of tea. Do I look like a cup of tea?
I have a cup of tea here, sir.
Oh, well, quit bragging about it and drink it. Don't let me stop you.
Very good, sir. Is there anything else I can do?
If there was, you wouldn't be a waiter. What's the matter with these people over here?
Morning, sir. I can take a drive this morning.
Yes, drive me to a drink. Who are you?
I'm the starter, sir.
The starter?
Yes, sir.
Well, don't start anything you can't finish.
Very good, sir.
What are you, a soldier?
No, sir, I'm not a soldier.
Nothing to make fun of, you know. What are you, coward? Go to war. Fight for your country.
But there's no war on now, sir.
Then start one. What do you want to do, put all the soldiers out of work?
No, sir.
Oh, good, let's have a drink.
I don't drink, sir.
Don't drink. First, you want to put all the soldiers out of work. Now you want to put all the saloon keepers out of work. Gee, you got a mean disposition. In fact, you've got the meanest disposition of any man I've met since I've been here. And I've certainly had a wonderful time here in Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh?
I mean London. I always get those two towns mixed up, you know, Pittsburgh, London. No kidding, it's a great town for fun. Makes Providence, Rhode Island look like 30 cents.
If you got nothing else to say for yourself, I'm getting out of here.
Shall I call you an handsome, sir?
You can call me handsome if you want, but it won't get you anywhere. Take it easy now. You seem like a nice little fella. If I lived here, we'd be together all the time.
Very good, sir. I'll call you a cab.
Call me anything you like. Sticks and stones will break my bones. Words will never harm me. Later.
I'm gonna keep this ceiling forever.
Here, what's going on?
Johnny Jones!
Johnny Jones, he's just outside the window!
Really?
Welcome to London, Mr. Jones!
Thanks, kid. See you at the Derby.
Johnny!
Hiya, Mac!
When I heard all that commotion, I knew it couldn't be for anybody but you. Oh, it's good to see you, Johnny.
Yeah, you think it's good to see me now? That's nothing. Wait till you see me at the Derby this afternoon, riding high on Yankee Doodle in the winner's circle with a garland of roses around my neck big enough to open a flower shop.
Hey, listen, I hope you aren't overconfident.
Is the son overconfident about coming up tomorrow morning? I'm going to win this race because I got to. I tell you, Mac, it means more to me than any race I've ever ridden in.
You know, I understand. Uncle Sam hasn't been licked by John Bull so far, he sure wouldn't want it to happen this afternoon.
Yeah, that, sure, that's the reason.
But not the only reason?
I forget how well you know me, Mac.
Yeah. What does she look like?
Well, I'll tell you, I saw a lot of paintings in Paris and sunsets on the river and all kinds of flowers waving by the side of the road in every castle and palace you ever read about in a fairy tale. And she looks better than all of them.
Oh, I see. Hey, you developed a sweet tooth for a certain kind of French pastry.
French pastry? I'm gonna be honest with you now, Mac. I could have sampled quite a bit of that when I was in Paris, and I wasn't even tempted. Because when you come right down to it, French pastry ain't worth 30 cents compared to American apple pie.
An American girl!
Could you imagine my heart going out to anything else?
Oh, I get it. She's gonna be out in the stands this afternoon, and that's why you gotta win.
No, she won't. That's the point.
Where is she?
In a convent school in California.
California?
Yeah. I spotted her in San Francisco before a race. She was in the stands with her friends, a little bit of a thing in a pink hat and all kinds of veils wrapped around her, dainty as you please. Then, just as I'm headed for the starting gate, I catch a glimpse of her. She's thrown back the veil, see? And there's a face to almost knock me off my mount. She looks me straight in the eye, opens that little angel mouth of hers, and out comes, "Ride 'em hard, Jonesy! I bet my shirt on ya!" I think I fell in love with her right then.
Yeah? But did you win the race?
One track, Mac. Of course I did. And she was right there beaming at me in the winner's circle. Later, I found out not only is she adorable, she's an heiress in the bargain.
An heiress?
Sure, that's why I gotta win that race today. You know, the prize is 20,000 pounds sterling.
Yeah, but why does the money matter if this girl is an heiress?
You think I'd marry an heiress and live off her money? What do you take me for, an Englishman? No, I gotta be able to support her on my own. That's why I came to Europe to ride in all these races, and this is the most important. Tomorrow morning, I can sit down and write a letter to her aunt. I believe her name is Mrs. Kenworth, and tell her I want the hand of her
magnificent... Wait, Mrs. Kenworth, the Copper King's sister?
The very one.
Well, she's here in London. She'll be at the race this afternoon.
Couldn't be better!
Oh, imagine. Anthony Anstey will soon be your uncle.
What?
Yeah, he's gotten himself engaged to Mrs. Kenworth.
What is it, Mac?
What's your girl's name?
Miss Goldie Gates. Why?
Oh, I was afraid of that. Johnny Anstey has arranged a match between Miss Gates and the Earl of Bloomsbury.
The devil!
No, I'm afraid it's true. Anstey's been telling everybody.
Anstey?
Yeah.
Matt, there must be something behind this.
Well, evidently.
Is Anstey here?
Yeah.
I'll be right back.
No, now, Johnny, you keep a cool head. Remember, you got a big race this afternoon.
You're right, Mac, but Anstey's got some tall explaining to do. I've had my eyes on for a long time.
I'll tell you he was here! Mr. Jones.
Nothing doing. To a pretty girl like you, I'll introduce myself. Call me Johnny.
You're gonna win the race, Johnny.
What do you think?
Yes! Got any inside joke about the race?
You want a little tip?
Sure!
Pawn your jewelry, go into hock, and play Yankee Doodle straight to win.
Oh, Johnny, can you really do it?
I'm a freeborn American over 21 years of age. I guess I can do anything I please. I'm the kid, that's all the candy. I'm a Yankee Doodle dandy. I'm glad I am.
So's Uncle Sam.
I'm a real-life Yankee Doodle. Made my name and fame and boodle, just like Mr. Doodle did by riding on a pony. I love to to listen to the Dixie strain. I long to see the girl I left behind me, and that ain't a josh. She's a Yankee, by gosh.
Oh, say,
Hezekiah, mother's name was Anne Mariah, Yanks through and through.
Red, white, and blue.
Father was so Yankee-hearted, when the Spanish War was started, he slipped on his uniform and hopped up on a pony. Mother's mother was a Yankee, true, my father's father was a Yankee, too, and that's going some for the Yankees, my young
boss.
Thank you.
love to listen to the Dixie's train. I long to see the girl I've left behind me.
That ain't a job, she's a Yankee.
To meet me, Goldie, and when that happens, I, the Earl, shall abandon me, Goldie, leaving me, Goldie, free to become Mrs. Johnny Jones at last. What? Hand me your pen and pencil.
For what?
I am going to write my aunt a note, and you are going to deliver it as if it came from San Francisco.
Who is ever going to believe that you are an Earl? You don't sound like an Earl.
Just wait.
And look at you. You're too short to be an Earl.
Don't be silly. Everybody knows that royal marriages produce loony princesses. So why not short Earls? Everything is going to be pip-pip. Now read this and correct my spelling.
All right. Dear Aunt Annie, I have gotten word from abroad that you are arranging a match between myself and the Earl of Bloomsbury. I hear he cuts a dashing figure. Oh, Aunt, please bring him back to me in San Francisco as soon as you can, because I want to marry him and only him. Yours affectionately, Goldie Gates, San Francisco, May 31st, 1904.
You see? An added inducement. And if luck is with me, we can sail for home before the real Earl gets here. I am clever, don't you think? Oh, here we go. Here comes Anstey.
Mr. Anstey, you are never going to believe this. Guess who has turned up in London? May I present the Earl of Bloomsbury?
What? Well, this is a surprise, eh? Didn't expect you till next week.
Oh! A surprise. Couldn't contain myself, actually. Left a fox hunt meeting to rush down here.
Fox hunt meeting?
Yeah.
But you were in Germany.
Oh, I believe you misunderstood his lordship. He said he left off dachshund breeding.
Dachshund breeding.
Right down
dachshund,
here.
Dachshund breeding. Dachshund breeding. Of course. Ah, oh, it's Mrs. Kenworth.
Ride. And thank you for helping me, and thank you. Oh, you people are so sweet here in London, and thank you, and you're a cute one. And thank you. Oh, Anthony! Oh, well, good morning, Anthony.
My dear one, I have the estimable honor of presenting you to the Earl of Bloomsbury.
He's here. Oh! Oh, my!
I believe you already know Miss Fly.
Oh, well, yes. Well, good morning, Miss Fly.
Good morning, Mrs. Kenworth.
Well, what a great coincidence to meet you again on the very day I'm introduced to the Earl. Oh, well, I would have dressed in something more appropriate had I only known. But to be surprised like this, well, you'd have to pardon me, your earliness. Oh, your lordship, for not dressing properly, for, well, you see, I was out shopping, and I had no idea that it was the day you said next week. It was a surprise, and when I had a hat and a dress, and I was all ready to... Oh, dear, am I babbling?
Not at all, my dear.
Not a bit of it, not a bit of it. You're entrancing, actually. You see, I was rather hoping to meet Miss Gates, you know, and so I went out and I bought a box of candy.
Oh, she's not here.
Oh, really?
Oh, well, she's in school in California.
California. Oh, California. California, California.
Oh, yes, and I have a note from her, which she asked me to deliver by hand.
Oh, well, thank you, Miss Fly.
You're welcome.
Oh, her dear handwriting. Dear, dear, dear. She has some nice things to say about you, your lordship.
Oh, well, how could she have heard? I didn't. Did you? Oh, well, would you care to see her likeness?
Oh, darling, what an excellent idea. Love to see a picture of it. Oh, good show. Marvelous, girl. Oh, absolutely yes. Marvelous. Wouldn't you agree?
Oh, yes. You will come to the Derby with us, your lordship?
Well, Mr. Anstey, here you are.
Keep a cool head. Well, Johnny Jones, the hero of the day. What an honor. May I present the Earl of Gloom?
Never mind all that. I gotta talk to you.
Now, Johnny, certainly you can't mean to...
Can it, Anstey?
I beg your pardon?
You heard me.
Well, Johnny, you'll have to forgive him, eh? Many of the better jockeys are this way on racing days. You know, the sporting temperament. You'd better be getting out to the track now, eh, Johnny? Good luck, old fellow.
Cut the gobbledygook, Anstey. You're playing a crooked game, and I'm going to find out what it is.
Temperament or not, Johnny, you're going too far.
I haven't even started yet. I'm going to expose you for the fortune hunter you are.
Fortune hunter?
How dare you speak this way in front of Mrs. Kenworth?
Mrs. Kenworth? Hi, I'm Johnny Jones. I think it's about time you got put on the square about your boyfriend here. My pal McGee's been telling me some pretty dirty facts about
him. Why, you young hoodlum!
Why, Anthony, what does this mean?
I'll tell you what it means. I'm hoping to be engaged to your niece. Have been ever since I left Frisco a year ago.
What?
Well.
Do you hear this? This common jockey, this rat of the stable, wants to be engaged to your niece.
Oh, this man is mad. Goldie has an understanding with the Earl of Bloomsbury.
What do you say to that, your steamship?
A big joke, isn't it? A jockey engaged to an heiress.
Well, yes, it's a gigantic joke.
Oh, is there no protection against a public insult from a madman?
Is there no protection against a woman of your sort, Mrs. Kenworth, to force upon a young girl an outrageous marriage to a cur who would sell himself for an American bankroll? And I believe you called me a rat, Anstey.
And that's what you are. And for this insult to my fiancée, I will drive you from every track in this world if it takes every dollar I possess.
Every dollar you possess is covered with the filth of ill-gotten gain. You've turned every trick known to the racing world, fixed your jockeys, pulled your horses, and fooled the public time after time, and you call me a rat?
And that's what you are.
Well, I wasn't too much of a rat to receive this check from you yesterday. But I don't want your kind of money. And there's your check back. There it is, right square in your face.
I am not through with you yet.
Come on, McGee. Let's get out to the track. We got a race to win.
Oh, isn't it lovely? Oh, do you know, Anthony? This is the first racetrack I've ever seen, and everything seems so very dignified.
Well, of course, my dear. But what did you expect?
Well, I thought there might be all kinds of... Well, I expected it would be... with, I don't know. It's just that one hears of so much scandal connected with horse racing.
And do I seem the sort to be connected with scandal?
Oh, no! Oh, certainly not!
Ah.
And how awful to be publicly accused by that dreadful jockey.
Now, the poor fellow, I fear he's gone mad.
Well, he must have.
By the way, my dear, might I borrow the letter Miss Floribel delivered to you from Goldie?
Why, certainly. It's right here. There it is.
Thank you, my dear. I wish to answer it as a means of introduction.
Oh, Anthony. How thoughtful of you. I feel sure that Goldie will take to you as I have.
Oh, perhaps not precisely as you have.
Oh, Anthony! Oh, you are embarrassing me.
Well, you can't expect a racetrack man not to be racy.
I expect I can. Oh, you are very different from Mr. Kenworth. He was more retiring. In fact, he retired every evening to his room with a book.
Well, I don't think that my evening devotions will be quite so literary.
Oh, Anthony, you shouldn't talk to me in this fashion.
Shouldn't I? Don't you like it?
Oh, Anthony, we are in public.
Yes, and I can't wait for the day that we're married. And in private. But the Earl and Miss Florabelle are waiting for me at the main gate. Will you come with me?
Oh, no, thank you. I'll just wait here.
Well, I shan't be long, my dear. And I meant what I said.
Oh, Anthony. What a wonderful change has come into my life of late, in a happy way. Oh, what a glorious feeling of not having long to wait for the happy day. Softly the secret is whispered, when heaven has something to say.
Kept you waiting, my dear.
Oh, no, Anthony. I was lost in thought.
Good afternoon. Oh, by Jove, what a finger that for Joe, Eric.
Good afternoon, Your Highness. Miss Fly.
You know, I feel sure Miss Gates will be as impressed with his lordship as we are.
Oh, how good of you to say so.
Oh, she's obviously dying to meet you. It's my hope that we can return home as soon as possible. Oh. You will accompany us, won't you, Your Highness?
Oh, thank you so very much for inviting me. I'll go right home.
Hardy do, Anstey.
Well, well, what a fine surprise. Ladies, Lord Bloomsbury, may I present Mr. Sing Song? Mr. Sing Song here is a sports reporter.
A reporter? Then that's it. You look familiar to me, Mr. Sing Song, and I've been trying to place your face. You must have covered a story in San Francisco.
Ooh, San Francisco!
Oh, my water on the other. Oh, don't I feel worldly today? Oh, but what's that?
Well, someone important arriving, I suppose.
Important? You think it could be King Edward and Queen Alexandra?
Shall we go and see, my dear?
Oh, go and see. Go and see. We go.
Do you really think Johnny Jones is worth all this?
Oh, yes, he is.
Oh, Johnny Jones, my whole life! Oh, absolutely, your lordship. Well, little Johnny Jones, don't tell me they were doing all that cheering for you.
I don't have to tell you, do I?
They seem to think Johnny's already won the race.
Sure, they probably got the same crystal ball I have.
Oh, I see you're the same shy kid I've always known and loved.
Say, you're keeping kind of funny company, aren't you, Floribel?
Oh, a lot funnier than you think, Johnny.
You may have a fancy title, pal, but in my book, you're still a little skunk.
Well, wait, are you addressing me?
Oh, get out of here.
Well, I won't stand for that.
I'll see you at the victory party, Floribel, and come by yourself.
Oh, come on, Johnny. Now, you ain't letting that fracas with Anstey get the best of you.
Of course I ain't. I'm saving my best for Yankee Doodle. And as for that crumb bum Anstey, I'm going to see he's wearing a striped suit soon, and I don't mean the kind they make on Savile Row.
Listen here.
Are you speaking to me?
Certainly I'm speaking to you. Am I supposed to be mad at you?
Now look, I am very busy.
Jeez, he's got a mean disposition. I want to find Jones, a jockey.
Well, what do I look like?
I'm ashamed to tell you. Take it easy now. You seem like a nice little fella. If I lived here, we'd be together all the time. Come on, let's go for a drink.
No, thanks. I got a ride this afternoon.
Glad to hear it. You wouldn't want to walk home in an outfit like that.
Can you believe these people over here?
Now, look, what are you doing here?
Good question, my friend. Don't know the answer. Went down to the pier in New York to see my friends off. Went to a little party in the stateroom. Next thing I knew, I was 3 days at sea. I never even got a chance to say goodbye to my wife.
I've been wanting to do that for years.
Never mind that. I sent her a postcard as soon as I got here. She never even wrote back. Gee, she's got a mean disposition.
If you're looking for Jones, that's me.
Oh, yeah? Would you like to know what I think of you?
Hey, watch it.
That's all right. Tell me, what do you think of me?
All right, I will. You're a Yankee Doodle Dandy. A Yankee Doodle do a tie. A real line nephew of your Uncle Sam. Born on the 4th of July. And you are gonna win the Derby. What a victory you'll enjoy. Yankee Doodle came to London just to ride the pony. You are the Yankee Doodle, you are the Yankee Doodle, you are.
Who is that?
Whoever he is, he made me feel good.
Well, I'm glad you feel good.
I do. I just wish Goldie were here so much.
Johnny, you said you weren't going to worry about that Earl of Bloomsbury business now.
Who's worrying? Goldie had never consent to marry that lapdog. Anstey and her aunt and the whole cockeyed world could try to force her, and she'd just dig her little heels in all the harder. See, she loves me, Mac. Isn't that the grandest thing you ever heard? You ought to read her letters. Every one of them makes me know all the more that I have her heart, just like she has mine. You think some pipsqueak girl could ever shake my faith in that? With blue skies, blue as her eyes, nothing could go dead wrong. And come rain, I won't complain. I'll sing the same love song. I know my darling feels the same. Our love's no temperamental game. On blue days, we'll never gaze. They'll never come along. For blue skies, gray skies, cloudy, rainy day skies. thought I was catching a whiff of the stables. Didn't realize you were around, Anstey.
Johnny, I'd like to apologize for what went on in the hotel.
And I'd like you to just stay out of my way.
I'm on the level, Johnny. Will you hear me out?
Leave him alone, Anstey.
I'm asking you, Johnny, please.
Nothing doing.
All right, I'll hear you out.
Johnny.
This is kind of personal, if you don't mind.
Well, maybe I do mind.
Don't fret, Mac. I can take care of myself. Well, let's hear it.
Well, I guess you think I'm a mighty big rat, eh?
No, rat is what you called me. I don't know a word low enough to describe you.
Johnny, I didn't want to embarrass you in front of the ladies, the Earl of Bloomsbury.
I'd like to see a crook like you embarrass
me. I'm telling you, Johnny, it's something kind of personal.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you and Goldie Gates.
Look, Anstey, you're not fit to mention her name.
I don't know how to break this to you, Johnny.
Break what? What is this?
A letter to my fiancée, Mrs. Kenworth, from Goldie in California. She's thrown you over, Johnny.
Oh.
Here. Read it yourself.
Please bring the Earl to San Francisco. Because I want to marry him and only him.
I couldn't tell you that in front of all those people.
Sure. Thanks.
Well, these things happen sometimes.
Right.
Say, I'm wasting your time. You got a race to win.
Yeah, the race.
Hey, come on, Johnny, it's almost time.
Yeah, sure, Mac.
What? Hey, what's the matter? What did Anstey say to you?
What? Anstey, nothing. He just apologized.
No, something's wrong.
No,
Johnny.
Leave me alone, McGee. I'm fine.
We did exactly what you said.
Yes, we put everything on you and Yankee Doodle.
That's swell.
What's the matter with Johnny? Where's that moxie?
I don't know. I'm worried, Flo.
You can do it, Johnny.
You better do it, Johnny. I got me wages riding on you.
Come on, Johnny. You gotta snap out of it. You gotta step lively. Remember what you told me about winning this race? Think of your Goldie.
Sure. I'll be thinking of her all the time.
Good luck, Johnny. Success to you. All the best.
Money's as good as in me pocket now.
I wouldn't be so sure.
What do you mean, Johnny?
All right, I'll tell you. I've got evidence that Jones plans to throw the race. You saw him, McGee, when I confronted him with my suspicions. He looked mighty blue for an innocent man.
Yeah, but I don't believe what you say for a minute.
Fine, you believe what you wish. I've changed my bet, though. I've put everything on British boy to win, and I'd advise each and every one of you to do the same. All right, you stick with Jones. You'll see where it gets you.
You'll get us the winner's circle, that's what it gets.
There they are, going to the post, all in good condition. That Yankee Doodle on the end, wonderful position. Look at him rear, he's broken line, he's simply wild to run. Now they're back in line again, there's the starting gun. They're off!
Come on, Yankee Doodle, we have got the whole caboodle, and you run, hurry up!
Yankee takes the lead!
Come on, break away, you're showing how to hurry up, show them speed!
At the quarter, he's gaining. At the turn, he's reining his horse.
Go, 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 double back and go!
At the half mark, he's cruising. What seems to be losing his lead.
Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up.
Gentlemen, it's all over. British boy has won the English Derby. And as for Yankee Doodle, well, he can go back to America in defeat.
Guess I let you down, kid.
Well, Johnny. I don't know what to say to you.
Isn't much you can say to a loser, is there?
Bit more than a loser.
I'm saved. Johnny, what happened
to you? What do you mean? What is this?
Mr. Anstey here has suggested that you have thrown the race.
Thrown the race? That's a lie, Anstey. You know it. Those words are going to take. Anstey's are mine.
There'll have to be an investigation, I'm afraid. You'll be ruled off the track until all the facts are made quite clear.
I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy. A Yankee Doodle, do or die. Yankee Doodle came to London just to win the Derby. I was that Yankee Doodle boy.
Johnny?
You mean you still want to?
Well, of course I do. Why wouldn't I?
Goldie, he threw the race. You saw him do it.
I saw him lose the race, and nothing else has been proven.
You know, if you had any sense at all, you would turn into yourself again and marry the real Earl of Bloomsbury.
Then I don't have any sense, because I'm not marrying anyone until Aunt Annie lets me marry Johnny Jones. I'll stay in disguise forever if I have to. I don't care what you say. Oh, or better yet, you tell Aunt Annie everything. I'll throw myself overboard, and wouldn't you just love that? It would make the best story of all. Excuse me. Good day, my man. I'm the Earl of Bloomsbury.
Ah, yes. Good day, your lordship. Welcome aboard.
Yes, splendid, marvelous to see you and all that rot. And, Captain, during this voyage, I wish not to be bothered by those dreadful newspaper people.
Well, Miss Fly, crossing with me again, I see. Having a tiff with the Earl?
Something like that.
May I ask the cause?
Love, of course.
You and the Earl?
No, much more complicated than that. Oh, you see, Captain, the ship and the pier and the uniforms keep reminding me of something that happened a long time ago.
What was it, Miss Fly?
My first, shall we say, romantic entanglement.
What happened?
Sit down, Captain. I'll tell you. Joey was a sailor. Floey was his gal. Floey came to say goodbye. Floey longs for Joey every night and day, wondering if he truly true will be. But Joey's journey's ended. Joey goes ashore. There's another Floey waiting for him there. Joey meets her and he greets her. To a hug and kiss he treats her. Joey has a Floey whom he sings to everywhere. Oh, kiss me goodbye, Flo. Don't you cry, love, no. Will you give your sailor boy a thought so tiny when you know I'm away out on the briny? Oh, kiss me goodbye, Flo.
Are we agreed?
Oh, very much agreed.
You'll meet me at Saratoga on the 4th of July at the running of the American Handicap.
Saratoga? 4th of July?
And you'll have the money?
All the money? Saratoga? 4th of July?
And then we'll have a bargain.
Saratoga?
Andy, are you there?
Not a word about this. This way, my dear.
Oh, be careful now. Oh, do be careful. Oh, I hope that Goldie will approve of her trousseau.
Well, how could she not, my dear?
Oh, hello there, Mr. Sing Song. Are you sailing with us?
Not sailing with you.
Oh, well, what a shame. Well, will we see you again?
You betcha. Saratoga, 4th of July.
May we speak to you, sir?
Certainly, Captain. There's something the matter.
Are you traveling with the Earl of Bloomsbury?
Oh, yes. We certainly are. Why? Has something happened? Is he taken ill?
I'm sorry to say you're the one who's been taken, madam.
What do you mean, Captain?
I'm afraid he's a fake, sir. The real Earl has sent word from Germany that someone is impersonating him. Whoever he is, he's aboard my ship.
And we'll find him, Captain.
Oh, Anthony, wait! Oh, this is so distressing. Oh, that cunning little Earl. Oh, Captain, what will they do with him?
Impersonating royalty? What's the penalty, officer?
Ain't this something, pal? I was their hero a few days ago.
Wait a minute, you're Johnny Jones. Well, if I'd have known that, I wouldn't have touched this stuff. Here, carry your own bleeding cases. So you threw the English Derby, did you? I hope the next horse shit gets on, falls down on top of you, and breaks your crooked neck.
I'm a hot favorite, Mac.
Yeah, you are in bad luck, kid. Nothing, it's shameful the way you've been treated over here. Suspended from the track like a common thief.
I did my best. Maybe I wasn't up to standard, but no man can say I ran a crooked race.
No, of course not. Hey, believe me, there are plenty of different definitions of crooked in this business. Now, I promise you, you're not the first
to... Wait a minute. Do you think I threw the race?
I didn't say that, Johnny.
No, of course you didn't. And no matter what you think, you're sticking by me, aren't you, kid?
I say we ought to be getting on board.
You go on ahead. I'll stick here on the dock for a while.
No, I don't like to leave you alone.
I'll be all right. Go on. Go ahead. You're cheering at me one day and spitting at me the next, and what a study it all is. By golly, life's a funny proposition after all. Did you ever sit and ponder, sit and wonder, sit and think why we're here and what this life is all about? It's a problem that has driven many brainy men to drink. It's the weirdest thing they've tried to figure out. About 1,000 different theories all the scientists can show, and never yet have proved the reason why. With all we've thought and all we're taught, why all we seem to know is we're born and live a while and then we die. Life's a very funny proposition after all. Imagination, jealousy, hypocrisy, and gall. 3 meals a day, a whole lot to say. When you haven't got the coin, you're always in the way. Everybody's fighting as we wend our way along. Every fella claims the other fella's in the wrong. Hurried and worried until we're buried and there's no curtain call. Life's a very funny proposition after all.
Even if he was a bogus Earl, it's terrible to think of him dead. Well, the blighter deserved it, I suppose, but to have died so young. Here are the two ladies who saw it happen. Would you be so kind as to tell us once more just what you witnessed?
romantique. He was standing by the railing, his hair blowing in the breeze. He looked at me with eyes tragic. Oh, how handsome he was.
You thought so? He didn't appeal to me at all.
He gave me this and this, and he said, beautiful lady.
Oh, please! He just jumped overboard. We have to make a five-act opera out of this?
Well, I'm sorry you had to witness this tragedy.
Au contraire! It was a beautiful sight to see. I shall never forget his face. Never, never. Jamais!
No, I guess you won't. Say, Captain, do we have the makings of a poker game aboard ship?
Well, Miss Fly, your friend Tim McGee is crossing with us.
McGee? Well, that's the best news I've heard all day. Tim McGee is the worst poker player in the world. By the time we hit New York, I will own his shirt. Coming, mademoiselle?
In a moment, Florabelle.
Sorry, miss. Say, who are you?
Oh, I am Rosario Franchette.
Amazing. For
and
a minute.
And you are Monsieur Little Johnny Jones, is it not right?
Right.
Are you sailing tonight?
Yes, mademoiselle.
Ah, then I will keep your company on the crossing, yes?
Oh, I don't think you'd want to do that.
And why not, Monsieur Jones?
Because I'm not very popular around here these days.
Oh, I know. The rest, no?
That's the ticket.
You are, how you say, a crooked?
Me? Not on your life.
You did not hold a race then.
No, I didn't. And I'd swear it on the life of anybody.
The life of who?
No one. A girl I knew once.
Once? And now?
She don't want me now.
She told you that?
I read it in a letter she wrote to her aunt.
Letter? When did you see this letter?
A few days ago, right before the Derby.
All during the rest, you
know. I don't want to talk about this now. It's uncanny. You look very much like her, at least in the dark here.
Then perhaps I can speak for her. And I can say no matter what people tell you, and no matter what you may read in the newspapers, this girl will be in love with you. She will tell you so with her own lips the next time you see her. So you must find her.
Sure, sure.
Oh, monsieur, I am a French girl, and we French know all about l'amour. I promise you, if you are worthy of this girl, she will always be waiting for you.
Who would wait for a guy everybody calls a crook?
But you are not a crook. You have just said so yourself.
A lot of good that does me.
Oh, you must stop this feeling. So sorry for yourself. Of course she will not like you like that.
What do you mean?
Do not come aboard this boat, monsieur. Stay here and fight to clear your name. If you are telling the truth, you can do it. She would want you to.
Who are you? Really?
I told you. I am Rosario Franchette of Paris.
It's crazy, but you're right. Goldie would want me to do just that. I can almost hear her saying the words.
You will stay?
Sure, sure, I'll stay and I'll clear myself, you'll see. Except...
Except what, monsieur?
Except I won't be making the crossing now. I mean, it would have been kind of enjoyable. What I'm trying to say is I like talking to you. Where will you be in America?
And what about her?
I ain't so sure she'll have me.
Oh, I see. How you say, covering your bets?
Maybe. But you're quite a girl.
Merci, monsieur. Ah, the pen. I must go.
It's only the first one. Just tell me where I can find you.
Ah, no. Not that way. Let you and I just say goodbye. Without a sigh, without a cry. It's best for you, dear, and best for me, dear. And what is with you, a living a life. You
and a spout, and make a stout out of this waste to other days. It's got to be, it's really so right now that you and I just say goodbye, and let's leave each other laughing when we go.
Leave each other laughing. It is kind of funny.
Funny? How?
Because if it weren't for Goldie...
Goldie! I see. No covering the bets.
I guess not. It's probably 1,000-to-1 shot my ever getting her back, but even with the odds like that, I can't play it any other way.
Mademoiselle Goldie would appreciate that.
Maybe. But meanwhile, I'm lonely and you're beautiful. I must be crazy. You even like me back. I can tell.
Never mind. We will find happiness, I know. Let's turn our backs and go. And do it now, don't hesitate. If we meet in the street, stop and say hello. We'll still be friends, I know. For good and now we separate. Let's end it with a handshake and a smile. Let you. Forget, she loves you very much.
Thank you.
Johnny, hurry up.
I ain't sailing, McGee.
What?
I'm sticking here, I'm going to that inquiry and clearing my name once and for all.
I think I can help you.
What? Sure, I remember you. Where's your flask?
No time for that.
Whitney Wilson, Pinkerton Detective Agent.
That's right, the Racing Commission. The Racing Commission's had me after Anstey for some time. I followed him here to England.
You sure fooled me, kid.
That's part of my job, but see. I got hold of some papers here that can incriminate him.
How'd you get them?
I picked his pocket just a little while ago, right?
But listen, I think I can use this to make him confess that he lied about you throwing the derby.
Can you? Can you do that, kid?
In 2 hours' time, I'll have a confession.
2 hours? The ship sails any minute. I won't know what's happened for 10 days.
I can send a cable.
Yeah, I guess so.
No. I have it. I'll send a signal.
A signal?
Sure, stick here on the pier. By the time we reach Lizard Island, I'll send up a rocket if I've gotten a confession out of Anstey.
So if Johnny sees a rocket go off, it'll mean he's in the clear.
Completely, if Anstey confesses. Watch for the rocket and keep your fingers crossed. Oh.
Thanks, kid. I'll be watching.
So long, Johnny. We're pulling for you.
Thanks, Mac. That'll help.
All ashore that's going ashore.
Wilson, say, Wilson.
Something you wanted to say to Mr. Wilson Jones?
No, not really. Just one American to another. Did you ever see two Yankees part upon a foreign shore? When
And the good ship's just about to start for old New York once more. With tear-dimmed eye, they say goodbye. They're friends without a doubt. Then the man on the pier shouts, "Let 'em clear," as the ship strikes out. Give my regards to Broadway. Remember me to Herald Square. Tell all the gang at 42nd Street that I will soon be there. Whisper of how I'm yearning to mingle with the old time throng. Give my regards to all Broadway and say with the old time drum.
In disguise. I'm not supposed to be here. I've been ruled off every track in the world.
Oh, terrible, terrible.
You said it, I'm ruined, but I had to come here to meet you, remember?
Sir, at Uga, what a Goliath in song, remember?
And you have the money?
Oh, 50 million yen. You have document?
Well, of course, of course.
Oh, please. Not read English very well, to read this part for me.
All right, but I have to get out of here. And in exchange for the sum of 50 million Chinese yen, I, Anthony Anstey, do hereby grant to the Peking Syndicate, as represented by Sing Song, a quarter share of the San Francisco lottery, which I own outright. Satisfied?
Oh, you betcha. Very satisfied.
You're under arrest.
What?
Whitney Wilson, Pinkerton Detective Agent York!
Give me that paper!
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 Brittany Wilson, Pinkerton detective agent.
I knew your face looked familiar.
You fooled me again, kid.
That's part of my job. Your friend Anstey here is not only a fraud at the track, he's the power behind the Chinese lottery.
Just think, all the time I thought you were so cosmopolitan, Anthony, and you were just crooked.
Gee, you got a mean disposition.
Cheer up, Mrs. Kenworth. Think how bad it'd be if you'd married him.
Of course, Johnny dear. And please, I've spoken to you about it. Call me Aunt Annie.
Sure, but you're not my aunt.
Well, still, that's the way I want it. It'll make me feel closer to Goldie in case she's never...
Oh, Aunt Annie, we'll find her somewhere. You gotta keep believing.
Johnny, she's
gone. I never
stopped
believing, not for a minute.
Oh, turn around, Johnny.
Hello, Johnny.
Hello, Goldie.
I hear you were cleared in that scandal. Congratulations.
Thanks. And congratulations to you, too. I mean, I hear you're marrying the Earl of Bloomsbury.
Well, I've been thinking about that lately. Why should I want a fancy foreign title when I could get a good old American name like Smith or Jones?
Goldie, do you really mean that? For McGee forever.
Yeah! Yeah! Captain Squirby, what a surprise!
Yes, ma'am. I've been reading in the papers about your trouble. I couldn't stop thinking about you. Something inside of me kept telling me things.
There's a tiny voice I hear down deep in my heart. There's a song so soft and clear down deep in my heart.
Oh, Captain, how very moving.
No song of an angel ever excelled the art of this refrain, this wondrous strain ever clear.
Wouldn't three make a better story?
Sure. Who's the third? You and Yankee Doodle?
Well, you got the first half right.
Florabelle, for a supposedly crack newspaper woman, you are very thick sometimes.
What? Oh, what, you mean me? Oh, well, but I always thought Mac and I were... But I wouldn't expect that we would be... Because I wouldn't...
To the race today?
What do you think? I got my girl, the track is fast, Yankee Doodle's raring to run, and one more thing!
What's that, Johnny?
Don't you people remember anything? Today's my birthday! you